In this segment of the lecture, we're going to discuss the ventral horn. The ventral horn, as you know, is motor and contains motor neurons. So everything on the ventral half of the spinal cord also has the same name of ventral everything. So ventral horn here, ventral rootlets that coalesce to form the ventral root, which then join with the dorsal root to become the spinal nerve. We'll talk a little more about the details of the spinal nerves in the peripheral nerve segment of this spinal cord lecture. But what I want you to think about is that in this area, you've got great big motor neurons here, and the information is leaving, okay, and going out to synapse on some sort of muscle. So all of these from different levels of the spinal cord, all of these axons are coming through the rootlets, coalescing within the root, and then joining with the dorsal root to form the spinal nerve. And so that's a functional unit. In the ventral horn of the gray matter of the spinal cord, we have a couple of different regional differences that we've already alluded to in some of the previous slides. So in all of the cord, you have this ventral zone here, which contains alpha motor neurons, okay? And those are the ones that are gonna go to your skeletal muscles. So they are somatic motor, and they innervate skeletal muscle. Depending on the region, you have also the intermediolateral cell column, which is in this intermediate zone, and this contains the neurons that are going to innervate your hollow organs. Ventral horn, motor neurons, and this area represents one of those enlargements. So this is like the lumbar enlargement. All of your areas have all of these alpha motor neurons, but because you've got limbs, if you were a snake, you would not have a lumbar enlargement because you don't have any limbs. But you have limbs, and so you have a lot more neurons that are going to innervate those limbs. So they're great big alpha motor neurons, beautiful, beautiful cells, long axons that go out to neuromuscular junctions, and they innervate somatic, i.e. voluntary skeletal muscle. The intermediate zone is only, or the intermediolateral cell column, the IML, is only present in a restricted area of the spinal cord overall. So from T1 to L2, it contains the preganglionic neurons of your sympathetic nervous system. I have a whole lecture on sympathetics and parasympathetics to make this all clear, but I want to introduce the concept that your spinal cord isn't the same all the way up and down. From S2 to S4 are the preganglionics of your parasympathetic nervous system. So the neurons here, depending on their origins, they're depending on the level of the spinal cord you are going to be either sympathetic or parasympathetic. They're motor neurons, they're efferent, and they innervate your blood vessels, your intestines, your heart, your bladder, and all of those kinds of things. Regional differences within the ventral horn are more dramatic than in the dorsal horn because of the two enlargements, both cervical and lumbar, that have lots of extra neurons to innervate your limbs, and because of the intermediolateral cell column in that intermediate zone, which contains the neurons of your autonomic nervous system, the sympathetics and parasympathetics. So basically, dorsal is pretty homogeneous from top to bottom. Ventral has more differences from top to bottom. In the next segment, we'll talk about the white matter.